What's up, guys? It's only me. Today, we will be making something. We'll be making a pink lipstick. For the ingredients, you will be needing cocoa butter, magnesium stearate, beeswax pellets, raw shea butter, avocado oil, and a mica powder of your choice. I chose a pink mica powder. For equipment, you'll be needing measuring spoons, a child's medicine syringe, and 4 lip balm tubes. And for a heating surface, you should have a hot plate, a single burner like this one, or an electrical stove. Alright, so you'll need to make a double boiler, or use a double boiler if you can. And the way I did this was I set up a pot and a bowl. I put some water in the pot and put the bowl over the pot. You'll be taking your ingredients, the cocoa butter, beeswax, and the shea butter, and you'll need to put those into the double boiler. It needs to heat up though, so you'll want to check it by placing your hand above it, just above it. Not right on it, but above it. It's not heated yet, so we'll wait. So I'm using 1 teaspoon of beeswax, 1¾ teaspoon of shea butter, and 1 teaspoon cocoa butter. That will be the base. And then I have 2½ teaspoons of avocado oil, which I will be placing. And then for the magnesium stearate, you will add just 1/4 teaspoon of magnesium stearate. For the mica powder, you'll just be needing 2 teaspoons, like I have here. Now I will put the beeswax in. Now, the cocoa butter. And now it is. You want to heat your mixture and make sure that it to stir so that it melts evenly. And once it is completely melted, you want to turn the heat down. This is why you want an electric burner or stove. because those vapors are coming off. And those can catch fire if you use a gas stove. Now let's add the oil and the mica powder. Just stir the mica powder and stir it till there's no more powder. Keep stirring it until all you have is a liquid that is pink. Now we will pour this lovely pink liquid into our balm tubes. We have to let this cool slightly though before we do this step. I forgot to add the magnesium stearate, but that's okay because I can add it now that I've remelted the mixture. Now I'll mix it in. So you usually want to do this step before you add the pigment. Because what it does is it makes it more pigmented. Gives it a more opaque feel. But if you want your lipstick to be more sheer, I would suggest skipping this step. Okay, you'll be taking your child's syringe and filling your lip balm tubes, like so. Once you're done filling your lip balm tubes, you can wait for them to cool. I would personally put them in the freezer for maybe 5 to 15 minutes. And then, after that's done, you can clean them up and it'll have leaves. Mine are cooling off right now, but soon they will be a beautiful mauve lipstick. And if you have leftovers like I did, you can use a miniature jewelry container, like the one that I have right here. You can find these at Hobby Lobby. They're pretty inexpensive. And what you can do is you can scrape off the excess with a spatula and wipe it into here. And that's it. So what you'll have is this beautiful mauve, because I chose a mauve mica, beautiful mauve toned lipstick. And when you unscrew it, you have to push it down a little bit because it will wind up a little bit stuck. And that is how you make, and it cleans off very easily. Look at that. All I'm using is a paper towel. You can use a tissue after you applied this if you need to take it off. And it cleans off really easily. And that is how you make a pink lipstick. Only me signing off. And remember guys, stay classy.